Morning everybody, it is the first day of week two of my vegan vlog diary. Right now I have got to a mid-afternoon lull. We've had our breakfast, our muesli, and I made a strawberry and banana smoothie for breakfast. So I'm gonna make Nathan a carrot, ginger and lemon and apple juice because that's what he wants, and I'm gonna make a green juice.
Check out this beautiful creamy orange colour.
Just finished our dinner. We had the remainder of that spinach, chickpea and red pepper curry that I made yesterday. So I had the last of that. I just wanted to show you this really yummy dessert because it is soy ice cream, chocolatey from Asta.
You've made it to Alton Towers.
And we've just popped into this really, really cool roller coaster restaurant. Not been able to eat anything because there's no vegan options, but it's been really, really cool just seeing all the food fly around the restaurant. So they were really nice. They've let me sit down, just pick my own food and just eat. We're gonna go check out more roller coasters and see where the day takes us. We're just stopping through for some ice cream, and Nitro Genie's one of my favorite ice creams. I've just checked, and I know it's a long shot, but I've said, do you have anything dairy-free? And there isn't. It's the only time I've really felt hurt not having dessert on this whole experiment.
We're on our way to our next ride. Everyone's having ice cream, and I'm having an apple. Staying strong.
Guys, it is the last day of week two, and we're heading off to the Northern Vegan Festival that's happening in Manchester today. I couldn't believe that over this experiment that there's going to be a whole vegan festival available for me to go to. So I thought I couldn't miss out. Hopefully get to talk to, some others that have been either a vegan full time and have made this a part of their lifestyle, or maybe others like me that are just kind of leaning into it or experimenting, who knows. But not sure what to expect. Gotta give these things a try, haven't you? And try my first vegan cupcake. Here goes. Oh my god, it was so nice. It tastes like real cupcake. We've stopped off for a little bit of lunch just because we're both starving.
And I'm having a bean stew, a Caribbean bean stew, which I got a little taste of before I had it and it was delicious.
This, however, does not taste nice. It's cucumber water and it tastes disgusting. Just got the schedule here. First one we went to was 10 step guides to going vegan, and it was really good, really informative. A lot of it was advice on healthier living, so different healthier alternatives to say if you don't want to have meat in it, or just how to add more fruits and vegetables to just everyday life, which was really good. So we're all done, we've finished. We only went to one more talk in the end because we wanted to go around all the stalls, and one of the biggest takeaways was the dairy talk. It was hard to watch, and it's definitely given me some food for thought. It showed some really horrendous footage of stuff that's happening on British farms. It's kind of a long story and I don't really want to go into it in a vlog because I've gone vegan for health reasons. So powerful stuff, a lot of food for thought, as I said. Really enjoyed kind of seeing the alternative health food stores, skincare and kind of everything kind of more natural, which I've enjoyed exploring as well at the centre. So it's been a good day.
Guys, thanks for getting to the end of the second week with me. I'm now on the first day of week three. It's all going well. I've had a couple of issues this week, not in terms of my own progress with veganism, more to do with what's going on the outside. One of the issues this week was when we went to Alton Towers, I was disappointed because all they do is give you two options. It's either fast food or fast food. Even if you weren't vegan or vegetarian, people who still eat those things want a variety of food. In a place like Alton Towers where there's nowhere else for you to eat, you think, shouldn't they provide more choices at least? I knew that this was going to be a problem, so I took a packed lunch and I took some carrot sticks and some protein bars and apple and other little bits and bobs to keep me full, and I took like a wrap with banana and peanut butter, which was really nice. We went to this awesome roller coaster restaurant and the waitress was really sweet, and she said, I'm not sure if we have vegan options, but what I can do is give you a big book of allergens. So she plonked this big book of allergens down on the table, and whilst everybody else was selecting from the menu, I was stuck with this book of allergens going through each page, and they had everything separated out. So they had the sauce separated, the pasta separated, and you'd have to go along all the lines and go, right, okay, I think that's vegan. When I got to the end of this book, I was just like, oh, I can't even be bothered. So I went up to another waitress and I said, I'm really sorry, I'm vegan. Do you mind if I just have my packed lunch at the table? I said, I'll buy a drink. My friends are all buying drinks. Can I just have my packed lunch? And she was really nice and said, of course, of course. The guys at the table were really nice. They didn't make an issue of it. There was no questioning. They were kind of like, yeah, you're vegan, big deal. I felt really good this week. I've carried on juicing. I've carried on like bringing lunches into work and eating more fruits and veggies, healthy snacking, which is great. I've noticed that my skin is really clearing up. I'm feeling more energetic. I went to the Northern Vegan Festival yesterday. It is like a vegan mecca. There are stalls galore, food, snacks, everything. It was amazing. I met this lady on a stand, said, how strict are you? And she said, no, I'm totally vegan, have been for 10 years, but it's not about being perfect. She said, it's about the intent, making the best decision for you. And she said, you know, if there aren't vegan options, then maybe live with the fact that the broth, it has got a little bit of dairy in it or what have you. So I don't know whether maybe I'll take that approach after the experiment, but it was really eye-opening. I think anybody drinking milk should at least know where this milk is coming from. I think that you should know where your food is coming from. It wouldn't be right of me to do this for health reasons and not kind of explore the whole kind of vegan world. All in all, it's been a really good week, and I'm just looking forward to seeing where the next couple of weeks take me. And if I carry this on, the moment I'm feeling like I may not carry it on full time, I'll have to see, because I really like to and I really like the lifestyle. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next week for my week 3 vlog. See you later, guys. Bye.